Now that you've been through the nutrition module, it might be helpful to use a computer ration evaluation software program to consider the same concepts in order to gain some confidence in either a supplementation program for a set of grazing cattle or balancing a diet, say a total mixed ration for a set of cattle that are, say, managed in a pen or in a sacrifice pasture. So the one we're going to use for this purpose is called OSU Cowculator. It's based in Microsoft Excel, and this is a ration evaluation software program. The calculator is based on three primary worksheets or components. The cattle worksheet is the area where we will determine or fine-tune the animal's nutrient requirements. The balancer worksheet is the area where nutrient requirements will be compared to the nutrients available based on feed ingredients that you include. And then the feed list is just a comprehensive list of feeds that you can select from, and it's customizable so that you can have feeds or forages analyzed for chemical composition, input your own data, and then later that becomes your customized feed list. So as an example, let's get started by modifying the cattle worksheet. We'll just go through an example with mid-gestation dry cows. And so what we'll do here is we'll go to the Select Class of Cattle section. This is a drop-down list, and you can see that Calculator deals with or can help you fine-tune or develop rations for all classes of cattle, including mature bulls, lactating cows, gestating cows, bred heifers, all the way up to growing and finishing animals. So for this example, we're going to select mid-gestation dry cow, and then we need to indicate to the software how many days in this feeding period. I'm going to include 90 days, since in mid-gestation we're really talking about the second trimester. Next thing we need to enter is the weight of the animals that are being considered for this ration evaluation. These are cows, and we're just going to assume they're mature cows, and on average the herd would have a mature weight and a body condition score 5 at weaning of about 1,200 pounds. Now, if we're talking about developing heifers, we'd want to include, let's say, developing bred heifers, we might enter 1,000 here, 1,000 pounds in the initial weight. But the software is going to need to know what these animals will weigh when they do become mature. And so that's what this input cell is for. We're going to enter 1,200 pounds here. We're dealing with cows that are already mature, so that the values in those two input cells can be the same. Expected calf birth weight is important during the third trimester. During late gestation, most of the fetal tissue and the fetus itself grows rapidly, and therefore the nutrients requirements are related to the birth weight and is especially important during that last trimester of gestation. In this example, we're going to be dealing with dry cows, so the level of lactation is not terribly important. But you can see here that if you're dealing with lactating cows or you're evaluating a ration for lactating cows, you have the option to select whether these cows, from a genetic standpoint, might represent cows with low milk yield. Here you can see these cows are projected to have about 19 pounds at peak lactation. Or if you change that to high genetic potential for milk yield, it goes all the way up to 29. The next thing we'll do to fine-tune or evaluate this ration, in particular fine-tune the nutrient requirements for these animals, is to enter a current body condition score. And this says initial body condition score, indicating where you should indicate the body condition score of these cows during the first part of this feeding period. Then the desired body condition at the end of this feeding period. So if these cows are relatively thin and we're starting off in a 4, and by the end of this 90 days, we wanted those cows to move up to a 5, we would reflect that here. And then The software would include the nutrient requirements necessary to accomplish that goal. But we're just going to start these cows in a five. We're going to basically tell the software we don't want them to lose body condition. We don't need them to gain body condition. So we're going to start in a five, and we want them to end in a five. All right, then over on the right side of calculator here, if you're unfamiliar with the body condition scoring system, you can click on that body condition score guidelines, and there's some good information there to help you better understand those scores. The last input on the cattle page has to do with the breed type of these animals. This is important for several reasons, but basically you just enter the percentage next to the breed type. And so, for example, if these are all Angus cows, purebred Angus cows, you just put 100% Hereford. If they are Hereford sired cows out of Angus females, you might include 50% Hereford and 50% Angus, for example. And you can put whatever percentages in there that you think represents the average of the herd that you're dealing with in this ration evaluation. The important thing is that the bottom of this column adds to 100%. So we'll just leave these for this example at 100% or purebred Angus cows. Okay, so let's go then next to the feed list, which is where we're going to select the primary nutrients, and that's going to help the software determine the nutrients available in this ration evaluation scenario. And you can see that there's a number of feeds available here for grazed forages is one category with quite a few tabular values, harvested forages. There's also a section to include concentrate feeds like grains or protein meals. Then there's a section for commercial feeds. And finally at the bottom, there's one section where you can enter mineral and vitamin supplements. All right, and so the first section of this feed list is units in terms of pounds. You can put these in 50-pound bags if you like. You can leave them at 2,000-pound or ton units. And then the cost for that particular feed ingredient related to the same units. That's important to make sure that those match up. And then from here, from the dry matter column to the right, everything else should be entered on a dry matter basis. But you can see that it includes details such as the protein concentration in the feed, TDN or energy value of the feed. These darkened columns are calculated for you automatically, and they cannot be changed. So if you happen to get a feed analysis conducted and get it back from the laboratory, and all they provide you with is, let's say, net energy for maintenance in this column or net energy for gain, what you would need to do is just manipulate the TDN column until you come up with a net energy for maintenance that matches your report. So that's how the feed list works. Now let's go to the balancer page and we'll work through our example here. And so this is where the software compares the nutrient requirements of the specific animal to the nutrients available from your feeding program. We'll just start off in this feeding category. We've got another drop-down list here. I'm going to go to harvested forages. Remember, we've got dry cows here. We'll just consider this to be a scenario where we're going to feed hay to these cows in a supplement. So I'm going to select, in this example, prairie hay, kind of mature prairie hay. In this case, I believe we have an option. Yeah, we have an option here for mature prairie hay and vegetative prairie hay. I'm going to select mature. And then we need to enter pounds that we think these cows would consume just to get us started. So you can put any number in here and the software will kind of help you fine-tune that number from there. So I'll include 20 pounds of prairie hay on these 1,200 pounds dry gestating cows. And you can see, I need to include 20 pounds down here in this feed intake section as well. So really you need to enter the feed intake in two different places. The reason that is designed this way so that you can enter this ration in pounds per day, like we're going to do in this example, or if you're blending a total mixed ration, you can enter it on a percentage basis. So we'll go ahead and enter 20 pounds down here so that those match. And then the way you evaluate feed intake is this intake ratio. And basically this is just calculating the predicted feed intake shown in this row and this cell compared to the amount that you indicated that you're going to provide. Now, recognize that this is on a dry matter basis down here, so 18.2 pounds of dry matter is equivalent to the 20 pounds on an as-fed basis we indicated above. Software says, we think these cows would actually consume more of this hay than that. It's saying this is about 20 pounds as-fed is about 84% of what these cows would consume. That's an indication that you should go increase that number. So we'll bump it up until we get to a ratio close to one. And that's how these ratios work, basically. You want to modify your inputs until these ratios are close to one, and you should be pretty close to a balanced ration in that case. We're close to one on the feed intake ratio. That suggests that we're fairly accurate or balanced from that standpoint. But if you go down here and you look at the protein ratio, notice that there's a caution comment to the side, and it says the protein ratio should be 0.98 or greater, in other words, close to one. Because when you have inadequate protein, the feed intake will be lower than what is projected above. And so the feed intake ratio would be inaccurate, and also the projected animal performance would be inaccurate. You would not expect these animals to consume as much prairie hay if they're short on protein, and you would not expect them to gain as much as the projected weight gain over there on the left-hand side. Consequently, we just need to go up here and find a protein supplement to fix that issue. So under harvested forages, we'll go look for a commercial feed product. And in this example, I'm just going to use Range Cubes, a popular product here in Oklahoma. We'll start off with a 38% cube, so it's a protein-rich feed, which is exactly what we need in this scenario. I'm going to start off with 2 pounds on an as-fed basis, so I've got 20 pounds of hay. Let me increase that so that my total down here matches 24. Notice my feed intake ratio is 0.97, so that's suggesting that these cows would actually maybe consume just a little bit more hay. So let me just increase that a bit. I'm going to increase that to a total of 24.3. And now we're real close to one on our intake ratio. Notice below, now with 2 pounds of the 38% cubes, we're now meeting these animals' protein requirements. In fact, it's indicating that we're about 5% over the protein expected to be required by these cows. Okay, so if we're satisfied with that combination of hay and supplement to these dry cows, the next thing we do is come over here and evaluate performance as an indication or a decision opportunity as to whether we have enough energy in this diet. So notice it says a projected average daily gain based on this ration in this scenario is 0.87 pounds per day. Desired average daily gain is indicated as 0.28. In this case, you know, since we're not trying to increase or decrease body condition score, the desired gain is primarily fetal tissue gain. And since we have 0.87 total projected gain, that means that 0.59 pounds per day is going to be maternal tissue, or the cow's actual body weight increasing, along with about a third of a pound increased weight from that fetus and the fetal tissue to support the fetus. All right, so if we were to change the scenario where we need more weight gain than this. In other words, let's say we start off with a set of cows. We'll go back to the cattle page here, and we'll say these cows are a little bit thin at the first part of this 90-day period. So we'll put them in as a body condition score 4. We want them to get to a 5 by the time they get into that third trimester. And so if we do that and we don't change anything else, we'll go over to the balancer page again, and I want you to notice that, you know, we're still relatively balanced in terms of feed intake ratio. The protein ratio still looks good. The only thing really that's changed is it says the desired average daily gain now has increased substantially, up to 1.2 pounds a day. And in fact, our scenario, it says these cows are going to gain just a little bit more, and that's because they're thinner, they're compensating. It requires less energy to achieve a pound of weight gain when cows are thin. And so that looks a little bit better, but we're still not meeting that goal. What that tells us is that we need to go get a little bit more energy, and we have adequate protein here. So what we can do is just go back to the commercial feeds, select a feed product that is slightly lower in protein concentration. So let's use a 20% cube and just feed twice as much so that we get the same amount of protein but twice as much energy delivered. Okay, so I increase the amount of supplement. That means that I'm gonna need to reduce the amount of projected hay that's consumed by these cattle, simply because, you know, when you feed more concentrate, at some point their hay intake is probably gonna decline slightly. So let me just, I'm gonna play with my hay intake until I get close to an intake ratio of 1.0. And at 21 pounds of hay, 4 pounds of supplement, my intake ratio is very close to 1. So I'm satisfied with that. I look down at my protein ratio to see if these animals are meeting, or if this ration is meeting these cows' protein requirement. It is at 1.01. Then I can go over to my projected performance to evaluate the energy adequacy in this scenario. And I see that projected average daily gain is 1.25 pounds, or 1.26. Desired is 1.19. That tells me that, in fact, here's another indication that these cows in a 90-day period, or actually in an 84 days, would gain one full body condition. So in 84 days, they would go from body condition score 4 to a body condition score 5. So based on my goals, I would say that this is an adequate ration. My daily cost is $1.39. And you could see that you could go back to your feed list and swap out some of these ingredients to see if you couldn't find a more economical scenario to accomplish the same animal performance goals while meeting their requirements. That's how Cowculator works. You can download Cowculator off of our website at beef.okstate.edu.